Last 5 turns. Yeah! It's time for our last 5 turns special event. I'm Toad, your host. Now then, let's check the standings. Luigi is in first. Mario is in second. Yoshi is second. Oh, they're both second. Same number of coins. Interesting. And Waluigi on his own board is in last place. But who will be our winner today? Let's find out in our very special victory prediction. And here to make the prediction is none other than... I am the Millennium Star. My tried and true prediction is that the home player will still win. I'm correct 9 times out of 10. And to Waluigi, our predicted winner, we award a present of 10 coins. And now for the last gasp, the last 5 turns. From now on, blue spaces and red spaces will be worth 6 coins each. And if 2 players land on the same space, a duel will ensue. Still need to see a lot of those. Good luck! With that, let the last 5 turns begin. Give me those duels. It's the only thing we still need to cover, minigame-wise. Okay, let's just move. The reverse mushroom I can't really use right now. Let's go to the only place of the board we have not been to yet. The right side on the middle section, where the second bank actually is. I don't have enough coins if I pass this guy. That's going to be a problem. So, let's make sure a minigame is being won next turn. Oh no, wait, of course the blue space gives me enough. Why did I forget about blue spaces? They're so common in Mario Party that I actually forget their function. They give you coins. A plunder chest, that's not going to be nice. Well, Luigi's not going to be a problem because he's going to use that lamp anyway. It's also one of the reasons why he won't get the star. Completely forgot he still had a lamp. There've been a lot of lamps this board. Well, with a little luck, the star gets shifted back towards Random Island. Because there's actually a second star space where it can get to. I believe there's 2 star spaces on Random Island. We haven't seen the western one yet. So that's actually always something I hope for whenever I play on this board. That actually all of the players are being forced to go to Random Island. But no, it's going to go move to start. But there's still plenty of time, so... It is a pretty compact board, I feel, so usually it does not take very long for people to get to certain places. Oh, we're getting a battle, I feel. I don't know why, but I feel battles coming up this turn. You can imagine how hilarious this place is if everybody is here. We're not getting a battle, okay. What? No coins at all? In that case, there'll be no battle. Come on, everyone, get busy! I believe this is the first time that happened in this Let's Play. But yeah, it's actually possible that the roulette for how many coins everybody is supposed to lay in lands on 0 and then the battle gets skipped. Really bad idea that it is in this game. Luckily, it is no longer in Mario Party 4. Wario, Mario, Peach, Yoshi, DK, Luigi. Yeah! Okay. Okay, I should have this. You were there. Mario. Then the crown. Yoshi. Luigi. Shy Guy was up top, because I can remember the bananas being at the bottom left. This should be correct. Never really understand these last minute change of minds the computer players always have. Yeah, perfect. Not that hard. It's only 10 items. I used to play these memory games a whole lot when I was younger, and usually I had to remember stuff like grocery lists and stuff like that, and those usually were 20 to 30 items long. So So something with only 10 items usually does not give me all that much trouble. Ooh, duel. You don't see those a whole lot, landing on the same space and then getting a duel. Waluigi does not really have that much, unfortunately, so... Well, we still have a lot of duel games to cover. And we're getting a new one, Bowser Toss. The title's already filled in because of this being a different... But still, spin Bowser by the tail and toss him as far as you can. That's what we're doing here. You repeatedly press A to spin Bowser and adjust your angle with the control stick to throw him further. Both repeatedly press A and controlling the angle with your control stick are important in giving Bowser a big toss. So it's basically a button measure, but with a twist. And the best way to do this is to first get up to speed. Don't touch your control stick at first. First, get up to speed. The more you press A, the faster the spinning will become. And only once you think you're spinning fast enough, then start controlling your angle. Because I've noticed if you start doing it at the same time, controlling your angle and pressing A, that is a little bit harder to do. Because usually I control my control stick with my left hand. But I also button mash with my left hand. So in order to make sure I can use both my left hand inputs optimally, I usually first start button mashing. And only once the time is almost up, then control the angle. Because obviously if you don't put an angle in, you'll throw him horizontally and the Bowser won't get thrown very far. But you also don't want to angle him too vertically, because then you'll just throw him straight up and you'll also get nowhere. So finding that perfect balance, that is the gist of that minigame. But okay, what did I miss? Still explaining a few things about Bowser Toss, and in the meantime, the board has still continued, of course. Okay, the happening star really is going to be random who gets that, because this is another board where happenings happen left and right. Yeah, you're obviously getting an item game. No way around it. Ooh, there's a magic lamp in there, and a dueling glove. The dueling glove I actually like to see, because that can mean another chance for a new minigame. Yoshi and his warp blocks. I should have known. He already has two now. He didn't even use his first one yet. Snowball Summit. This is a minigame we've seen way too much already. Can't wait to see this one on Super Hard. This one's really fun on Super Hard, I feel. And maybe in Mario Party Superstars too. Didn't really like the way it looked there, but still. I did talk about how this minigame is in Mario Party the top 100 last time, but... did not quite mention that the new upcoming Mario Party game, this minigame, apparently also returns. Did not quite remember that last time, but... I've watched the trailer again in the meantime, and I noticed... Oh, Snowball Summit's also in it. Oh, let's not lose this one. Oh, Mario. Cooperate here. It's an ultimate goal to get a mega snowball to throw people off. Finish! But it would be nice if you actually cooperate with me. I'm the best. Okay, we have three more turns. Reverse Mushroom can't really use it quite yet. What do you have for me? Mushroom... Skeleton Key. Or I'll just go for Warp Lock. You know what? You didn't expect that, didn't you? Random island. No. It's on the right side of the map, but not quite on the location I wanted it. Ah, we'll get another chance. There's still story mode coming up, so hopefully story mode's playthrough of Waluigi's Island will be a little bit more random island based. I could go there deliberately, but I don't really get the chance to do so. Okay, he's out of there. Switch with me, please. Thank you. Unless a really scary space starts appearing next turn, I might start making it my home now. But I'm not going to stay there if chance times or Bowser spaces start appearing there. Then I'm still out. It's really fun there, but I don't want to kill myself there. Okay, Wiggler again. We've seen all of the faces in this minigame, so there's only three faces that can appear here. Toad, Mario and Wiggler. And now for the hardest one. Nope, failed. Mario and Waluigi got it, but they screwed up a couple of other things. So, I still win. Yoshi only 8 points. I'm the best. He didn't get a single one. But okay, now the question is, am I going to have fun on Random Island, or am I going to have fun with my warp block? Because in all honesty, I still want to get that star, and Random Island is a lost cause anyway. And at least someone will be here. Unless I switch to Yoshi again. Which I do. As if nothing ever happened. Okay, gives me that star. I need to go left. Thank you. Random Island is fun. I could go there now, but the star is even more fun, let's be honest. Ooh. I was afraid that might happen at some point. Can't I ever do one board where I don't get a hidden block star or a chance time star? Is that really impossible? See, at least these guys get items out of their hidden blocks. I'm the only one who gets stars out of them. But like last time, this time I don't really mind. Still annoying that it happened again. But I still would have won this board, so I didn't need it. And I still can't believe I'm calling it annoying that I get... I got it. If Yoshi does not get a hidden block now, then I'm calling this game rigged. Yoshi, get a hidden block. Every single player gets a hidden block this turn. Oh, apparently it's possible. You don't get a hidden block. What the hell? Three hidden blocks in one turn. This game is screwing with my mind. Luckily, we still have the minigames. Those are the only things that are normal around here. this is going to be tough. It's way too far. No. Close, but no. Usually, there's always at least one computer player that gets it in. Well, not like that. It's even worse than what I did. Mario Golf. Nope. Don't tell me I'm going to win this one. Yeah. They're all around the same position. Finish! Well, you don't see this very often on hard difficulty. That nobody is able to get a hole in one. Usually they do. But even if you don't, the closest one to the pin wins. That's basically how it works. It's pretty rare. But nobody gets it in. Hey, I had to do something with that thing. Oh, oops. Well, I got that hidden block star, so... can't really complain that I didn't make it to this star. Okay, Bowser. What do you have? Reverse curse. Thank you. We have not seen that in its proper glory yet, so luckily this last minute appeared. And unlike last time it appeared, this time we do have a couple of players left to play. I wonder what will happen with Yoshi, because I just reversed cursed him. Is that also going to pile up? Like with the poison mushroom. Ooh, Mario. I almost gave you a star. The only problem is you didn't have enough coins. Interesting. Okay, this time we do get a battle. No zero coins this time. Let's get a good one. That is not a good one. But I can still win this one. I did win it the first time it came by. With a beautiful green color that can always give me luck. Even though it doesn't always. Mario's out first. Get my green. I'm actually surprised none of the other players have picked green before me. Actually, able to pick it every single time. Apparently everybody hates that color. Luckily they do, because I can pick it. Stay alive one more time. Okay. At least I get some coins. And green is actually also one of the colors that stays in the whole time, because of course, the moment the player starts decreasing, the number of spaces you can select also decreases, so two colors disappear from this platform, but the green is actually not one of them. Green, blue and red actually stay behind. In the final turn. Lucky me. And it's all thanks to green. Oh, Waluigi's actually going to encounter this roulette. Well reversed. Then it actually works like this, as you can see. You can just pick your own direction, with the exception of the one you came from. Also interesting to see. Yeah, the reverse mushroom does have a couple of interesting aspects to it when it comes to facing intersections. Some really weird stuff can happen. But apparently the reverse does not pile up. I wouldn't even know how, but... and it also doesn't get cancelled out. Reverse plus reverse does not mean you get thrown in the right direction again. It just stays a regular reverse. And last time I played this minigame, I was also the solo player. Let's get to the right, so you guys don't get that back. That's usually the strategy I go for. If I can't get the back, then you guys can't have it either. I'm not going to make that. No, 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 Mario. No, Mario. Bad Mario. Couldn't quite prevent him from getting it. I still got the most. But that could have been better. Okay, this is how we end. One star for Mario, one star for Yoshi, two for Waluigi, four for me. And of course still a couple of bonus stars approaching. So I could pretend this is still exciting, that it's still everybody's game, but in all honesty, once again, it isn't. Because even before the bonus stars get handed out, this is already over. Nicely done, everyone. Here are the results. First, let's look at the number of stars collected. You have each collected this many stars. Just said so already. I have as many stars as the other players combined. 4. Next, let's look at the final number of coins. You each ended the game with this many coins. 97 for me. And the other players are not even at 30. Waluigi was close to 30, but no. Bonus stars. Let's get everybody ready, because the minigame star is getting handed out first. And that is the same player every single time, so why wouldn't it be this time? Luigi. The coin star is actually a star that I didn't get every single time. Usually I do, but this time around I still got it. I was at 100 plus at some point, until some dynamite exploded. The happening star is definitely really random in a board like this. But the player who landed on the most of them was Waluigi, the home player. Set off the most of his own traps. Well, let's announce the winner. Fourth place goes to Mario. Third place goes to Yoshi. Waluigi gets second place because of that bonus star. He was in the last place for the longest time in this board. He still managed to get second on his board. But he couldn't quite get close to me. Even on this final hardest board, the computer players weren't able to keep up with me, apparently. And there goes the final board. There goes Waluigi's Island. Making it 6 out of 6. Which is a pretty big contrast in comparison to Mario Party 7's board playthrough I've been doing on my own time. This last couple of weeks where I won only one board. Interesting how I won all of them here. And pretty easily even. But we're not done yet, of course. Don't forget that. There's still Duel Mode coming up, which also has its own set of boards. But first, let's go to the detailed results of this one. I almost got 200 game coins in this board, which is a pretty big landmark to reach. I haven't been able to reach it a single time. You do need some bonus minigames for it, unless you win every single minigame. Couldn't quite do that. We're still a couple of minigames that got the better of me. Frigid Bridges, most of all. Most number of coins, 127, until the point where I got destroyed. 13 blue spaces for me and Yoshi. It's the space most people land on anyway. Nothing too special about that. I didn't get a single red space. Waluigi got 6 happenings. I got 4 alongside Mario. Yoshi only 3. But still a lot of happenings. Altogether 17. Which is definitely a lot. In a board like this, that usually happens. No chance times. So didn't get a star that way, but there was still a hidden block. Every single time, those hidden blocks. They just won't leave me alone. 2 Bowsers. One of them giving us an interesting reverse curse. 3 battle spaces, even though we've only seen 2 battles, because one of them ended on 0. Item spaces, not too much special here to say. No banks again. Interesting how we got so many bank spaces the very first board we played, and after that, 3 boards where not a single bank space happened. Interesting. What a contrast. No Game Guy, so the final Game Guy minigame, still up in the air. Game Guy's roulette. When will you show up? Perhaps on Duel Mode, because in the Duel Mode maps, the Game Guy also is a little bit more frequent alongside the Duel minigames, so both of the sets of minigames we still have to cover get a bigger chance in the upcoming Duel Mode. Because that is up next. This has been the 6th and final board of Party Mode. Next time, we'll be doing something a little bit different. Let's close this off, because we're done here. Next time we'll return to the regular file, because this one I only played because of needing to have Waluigi Island unlocked. So next time we'll return to the regular file I've been playing. Even though Bowser Toss did appear here, that is still going to appear as question marks next time around. But at least we know we have seen that one officially. So next time, we're for the first time not going to go into the blue star on this game, but we're going to pick the red star. The Duel Maps, where we'll be playing one-on-one. Where 6 new boards and an entirely new way to play Mario Party will be played, because it is not the same as Battle Royale maps. It's actually something a lot different. It is still a board, but that's actually the only thing where the comparison stays. It's a completely different new way to play Mario Party. And that we'll be doing next week in multiple steps, because unlike the party mode, I'm not gonna do one board per week. The dual mode maps have a tendency to be a lot shorter, so I'll just fill out every single day in the week. We probably see 2 or 3 maps per week because of it, which is not a bad thing. But that's the way I'll be dealing with that. So I'll be seeing you then. Hopefully somebody's able to beat me, because this has been going way too easy. Let's hope the challenge is real next time in dual mode. See you guys next time for that. Treecks out. Thanks for watching.